You know my next guest as George Costanza on Seinfeld. He now stars in the upcoming show Hit the Road on the Audience Network. Please welcome Jason Alexander.
Hey, can I say something right off the top?
Uh-huh.
Thank you for your opening tonight. That was beautiful and necessary, and I was very touched.
Oh, you, you don't know what to say on a show like this, but something like that. But thank you.
Very nice. You know, I was thinking about it all day, and you know, I've been on social media all day, and everybody's talking about how you can't stop a madman. You can't stop a madman, but you can stop them from getting these weapons, and we're not doing enough to do it.
Hopefully, you got to have some hope, and that's possible.
But thank you for that.
Nice to see you again.
We've Thank
only
you.
Met once before.
We had a lovely dinner together.
We did, out in the suburbs.
I believe I sat next to your wife.
Yes, let's
and
move on.
And I think
on.
She was moved.
And but... I bet she was. Did you see who that was? Now, everybody knows it was George Costanza, but I think of you as a singer. Because on this, no, I'm joking, I'm not joking. On this stage,
yes.
When Dave was the host of The Late Show,
I crooned a bit.
You did.
Yeah.
Man of La Mancha.
Man of La Mancha. Sure,
you did
okay.
Don Quixote.
Yes.
My Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha.
My destiny calls and I go. And the wild winds of fortune shall carry me onward to whithersoever they blow. Whithersoever they blow, onward to glory I go.
Yes! We'll be right back! What? Anyway.
How have I not been cast in that role?
I don't know.
Of the thin string bean old man, the silhouette of the
Sancho.
Famous.
Hell of a Sancho. Baza.
That is my.
Or windmill.
Life. Yes, or windmill, exactly.
No, but you and I have one thing in common. I have a little bit of experience with Stephen Sondheim.
Oh, sure you do, yeah.
And you were in the original 1980 recast of Merrily We Roll Along.
Yes, I was.
I know 2010 Stephen Sondheim. What's 1981 Stephen Sondheim like?
Lovely. Lovely. Brilliant. Amazing.
Sure.
A difficult show. There's a wonderful documentary that Lonnie Price made about some of our time together.
Sure.
But it was one of those shows where, you know, I was 20 years old, and it's Sondheim,
wow.
And it's Hal Prince, and it's
wow.
You're working with the gods.
How do you land that gig?
I just showed up, and they went, it's gotta be him.
But it
was honestly, it was a mass cattle call, and I was right for that role, and it just worked out. But they struggled, and I was not part of the struggle. I had a character that was very clear in a show that was often unclear,
mm-hmm.
And so I was coasting along beautifully, having the time of my life. And every day they would rewrite massive parts of the show and put them in, but never me. I was fine. And one day I remember sitting in the theater and. And there was a lot of stress, but they were lovely men, and we were all kids, and they couldn't have been kinder, and they really took care of us, but there was a lot of stress. And Sondheim came out on the stage, and he was looking around like he was upset, and he looks into the house of the theater, and I said, oh, somebody's in trouble. Somebody's, ooh, something's up. And he looks in the area where I'm sitting, and he starts heading down that way, and I went, ooh, it must be somebody near me. Who could it be? And he comes up to me, And really upset, goes, never mess around with my score. And turns on his heel, and off he goes. And I'm like a puppy following my mother going, oh, I don't know what I did. I don't know what I did. Don't tell me. Don't walk away. Don't walk away. I had, without even knowing it, I had gotten so comfortable that he wrote a line of music that went, there's not a tune you can hum. And I got cocky, I guess. And I went, there's not a tune you can hum. And on that particular day, that's what I did. That I was the straw that broke the camel's back, and I apologized profusely. And then he was as sweet as we can be, and he is. We've collaborated since, but it was one of those things where God almost smote me.
Sure,
the
sure,
God
sure.
of theater.
Sure, sure. Honestly,
almost ended my life that day. Yeah.
Now you have a new show called Hit the Road
coming
out on the Audience Network. Now, for the few people in the audience who may not know what the Audience Network is.
like myself when they call.
What is the Audience Network? Yeah. And what has hit the road?
The Audience Network is the channel of DirecTV. It's the DirecTV channel. So if your television comes to you via DirecTV, you have the Audience channel.
Okay.
I was not fully aware of them either, and they've really notched up, and they're doing a lot of original programming. Mr. Mercedes was a big hit for them this summer. This is an original half-hour show. Hit the Road is, I sort of call it the Partridge Family on acid. It is a family.
I would watch that.
Indeed. It's a family band with a mother and a father and four kids. One of them is an adopted African-American kid trying to be America's next great family values wholesome band, and we all live on a tour bus together.
How many kids are there?
Hate each other. Four.
Four kids, and one of them is African-American.
Yes,
they
are.
So it's also This Is Us on acid.
It is indeed.
Wow. I'd like to see Seinfeld on acid.
I understand you did recently, so who knows? No, come on.
No, come on. Well, you got a show here in New York, The Portuguese Kid. It opens October 24th at the Manhattan Theater Club. The show is Hit the Road on the Audience Network. The man is Jason Alexander, everybody. We'll be right back with Ta-Nehisi Coates.